what is it, a Monday? And this is a Memorial Day. So this is one of those national holidays. Sovas and Don Rico Suave are correct. I'm Derek Knight, and I am going to be your host for the old Twitch quiz tonight, Metal Yoga Head. Sorry to disappoint you, but frankly, you've had way too much AJ already. Because I was supposed to host on the 6th, but I had pneumonia. And so AJ graciously stepped in and did that one. But Jerfad now must make an orange whip, and I believe Sovas gets a foot massage. So, hi, everybody. Hi, Numi E and everybody else in the chat. Heck yeah. It's nice to be, it's nice to be not dead. I was very close to dying, apparently. You know, I don't know. This is only like the third time. I think it's the third time in my life that I've had pneumonia, and I don't want to ever have it again. But the microphone tonight is a Shure Model 315. This is from 1952. And this was the general purpose gradient microphone. We now call these things a ribbon microphone. This is the same model that was the stage mic at Fannie Mae Duncan's now long gone Cotton Club here in Colorado Springs. And this is pretty much what it would have sounded like back in the 50s. So yeah, it's a real cool mic. I got this one completely refurbished, and the hat, it's the same hat. I've had the same hat. This is a Grunkle stand fez from Gravity Falls. So if you're a big Gravity Falls fan, you know what this looks like. If not, well, watch Gravity Falls. Anyways, we've got a big quiz for you, a big 7-round quiz. Like normal, most of the rounds going to be worth 8, but of course, round 2, the audio round, round 6, and the final random knowledge round 7, they're going to be worth 16 points. So when you blow that imaginary joker, you know, do that in one of those 16-point rounds, because it doesn't take a rocket scientist to know which one is better for your final score. Also, big thanks to Sovas, subscribed with Prime for on a 45-month streak, but I saw in the chat that should be 50, but you know, 45 is still pretty good. Still pretty good. Anyway, happy to be here. Happy to not be dead. Still a couple of coughing fits here and there. I've been hosting my live quiz the last couple of weeks with varying degrees of success. 2 weeks ago, I had to get through it with the hot toddies. Last week, I just got through it. But I think I broke a rib coughing. This is something you can do, and it still hurts a lot. So that's enough of me complaining. We are going to get started with the actual quiz. We're going to get started where we usually do. That is at round number 1. Round 1 tonight is called It's Big, It's Heavy. No, it's not me. Every answer in this round contains log together and in order. Every answer in this round contains log together and in order. L-O-G. So, yes, Sovas, I'm glad I'm alive too. Thank you so much. Here's question number 1. Number 1, you can reason this out. According to Mr. Spock, what L word is the beginning of wisdom, not the end of it? Question 1, once again, you can reason this out. According to Mr. Spock, what L word is the beginning of wisdom, not the end of it? Sorry, y'all. I just didn't have CloudBot turned on. CloudBot was turned off, and probably sleeping because it was a holiday. I thought, nobody's gonna need me tonight, so I turned on the CloudBot. So now you can do those exclamation point commands and get something. So yeah. Anyway, round number 1. It's big, it's heavy. Answers contain L-O-G together and in order. And we are at question number 2. Number 2, long before the dawn of Tumblr, programmer Jorn Barger coined what term for an online journal? Question 2, once again, long before the dawn of Tumblr, programmer Jorn Barger coined what term for an online journal? Round number 1. Tell me what you're drinking in the chat, just because hydration is important. I am having not an orange whip, but an orange Gatorade Zero, but I am also supplementing with a Vucaray. in a weird hula skeleton cup that I got from my Geeks Who Drink Secret Santa. So I got a Vucaray and I got Orange Gatorade Zero. Wisco, sweet tea, some delicious mead. I have yet to come across mead that isn't delicious. So if you come across mead that sucks, you let me know so I can just flat out avoid it. Round one, question number three. Number three, since the Apollo 11 astronauts ate cornflakes before they landed, you could argue that what cereal manufacturer has been to the moon? Question three, once again, since the Apollo 11 astronauts ate cornflakes before they landed, you could argue that what cereal manufacturer has been to the moon? Round number one, it's big, it's heavy, it's L-O-G. Answers contain L-O-G together and in order. And we are at question number four. Number four, this nightmare fuel is an ad for Flame, Burger King's meaty entry into the world of what dude smellifiers? Question four, once again, this nightmare fuel is an ad for Flame, Burger King's meaty entry into the world of what dude smellifiers? Round one, question number five. Number five, 11-year-old Daphne Keene couldn't legally be present for the casino scenes when she played Wolverine's young ward in what 2017 film? Question five, once again, 11-year-old Daphne Keene couldn't legally be present for the casino scenes when she played Wolverine's young ward in what 2017 film? Round one. It is big. It is heavy. It is log. Here is question number six. Number six. Founder Richard Hayne named what chic mall clothing chain after the social science that he studied in college? Question six. Once again, founder Richard Hayne named what chic mall clothing chain after the social science he studied in college? We are once again doing quiz. It's a quiz for you and for me and for everybody who's watching, which is like 91 people. So happy Memorial Day. We're in round number one and we just passed question six. And since time is linear, that means we're moving on to question number seven. Question seven, it's way too late to say sorry for enjoying Timbaland's hit 2007 remix of what One Republic guitar anthem? Question seven, once again, it's way too late to say sorry for enjoying Timbaland's hit 2007 remix of what One Republic guitar anthem? In a chat, Jerfad says, orange whip, not sweet enough. Well, does it need more orange? Or more whip, or do you just need to throw some simple syrup in there? Whatever you want to do, I guess. I mean, I know that when I made that orange whip using the original 70s recipe, it was freaking awful. I know that I had come up with an alternate recipe that I thought would be better. I haven't tried it yet because, I don't know, the first go around was such a disappointment that I haven't tried to mess with it. But I just stopped drinking for a while. Sometimes that happened because my 50th birthday was in March and we went to New Orleans. And then when we came back, I was like, you know what? I'm going to see how long I can go without having a drink. And I made it almost until the end of the pneumonia because I was like, fuck it, I need to have a drink. But I did it pretty good. It's about a month, month and a half. So it was pretty good for me. Regardless, we are in round number one. And we're about to move on to question number eight. Number eight, no BS. The oldest university in the Western world was founded in what northern Italian city known for its fine deli meats? Question eight, once again, no BS. The oldest university in the Western world was founded in what northern Italian city known for its fine deli meats? Yeah, my original goal was to make it all the way till I went to Dallas. I was in the Metroplex last weekend, so I got out in time to not get caught in the tornadoes. I was actually in Plano doing a show at the Plano House of Comedy, and it was recorded for Sirius XM. No guarantees that my stuff will make it on, but who knows? Maybe in the future you'll hear my weird Carnival Barker voice on Sirius XM's comedy channel. No guarantees, but it's an outside chance. Regardless, we have just completed the questions proper for round one. And so that means we're going to move on to the bonus question. Since 1916, what wooden construction set has pretentiously billed itself as America's national toy? I'm going to give you a little bit of time to get your entries in, and then we'll come back and talk about the answers for this round in just a little bit. Not like normal. It looks like y'all are getting that figured out pretty easily. So let's move on to the answers for round one, where all the answers have L-O-G in them together and in order. Question one. You can reason this out. According to Mr. Spock, the L word that is the beginning of wisdom, not the end of it, is logic, or logic, if you want me to go with the hard G every time. Number one is logic. Number two. Long before the dawn of Tumblr, programmer Jorn Barger coined the term weblog, or just blog, weblog at number two. Number three, since Apollo 11 astronauts ate cornflakes before they landed, you could argue that Kellogg's has been to the moon, at the very least in the stomachs and or colons of our finest astronauts. Kellogg's at number three. Number four, this nightmare fuel is an ad for Flame, which was Burger King's meaty entry into the world of colognes. The world of colognes, or colognes. Number four. Number five. 11-year-old Daphne Keene couldn't legally be present for the casino scenes when she played Wolverine's young ward in the movie Logan. Logan at number five. Logan. Number six. Founder Richard Hayne named what chic mall clothing chain after the social science he studied in college? That would be anthropology. Anthropology. Anthropology at number six. And here's number seven. It's way too late to say sorry for enjoying Timbaland's hit 2007 remix of what One Republic guitar anthem? That, of course, is Apologize. Apologize at number seven. And here is number eight. No BS. The oldest university in the Western world was founded in what northern Italian city known for its fine deli meats? That would be Bologna. Bologna at number eight. Your bonus, since 1916, the wooden construction set that has pretentiously billed itself as America's national toy, that is Lincoln Logs. What I like most about Lincoln Logs is that the guy who invented Lincoln Logs was one of Frank Lloyd Wright's sons. And this is a son that did not get along with his dad. And so as kind of a big F you to his famous architect dad, this is what he came up with. So Lincoln Logs. Round two is the audio round for the evening. It is also the first 16 point round of the night. So if you, if you are going to use your Joker, which is pretty much imaginary, it's up to you. And you do really well in this round, it's a good time to use it. If not, hang on to it, because remember, round six and the final random knowledge round seven are also worth 16 points. So anyway, let's find out more about this round. It's called Baby Got My Back. It's called that because it's sunscreen day, so we found a bunch of song titles. It sounds like brands of sunscreen. You name those titles and the artists as usual. 16 points are possible. That's 1 point for the title, 1 point for the artist of each song. I think you're going to do really well because you're all very smart. There we go. Number one.
But you're moving so carefully, let's start living dangerously. Talk to me, baby.
All right, round number two, 16 points on the line. Here's song number two. Round two, 16 points on the line. Here's song number three. One point for title, 1 point for artist. Round two, here's song number four.
I've got a crummy job. It don't pay near enough to buy the things it takes to win me some of your love. Every time I turn around, I'm looking up, you're looking down.
Your very good hint is that these songs kind of sound like sunscreen brands, so title and artist, here's number five.
Doing all these shows, I've been on the road, I don't care where I go, long as I keep paying. Bad little vibe, she been on my mind, soon as I get back, she can stay. Do this all the time, this ain't no surprise, every other night another movie get made.
Every other night another dollar get made, every other night started with a good day. I feel like a child, I got boogers in the face.
1 point for title, 1 point for artist. Round two, here's song number six. Round number two, here's song number seven.
Where the sun is always out and you never get old, and the champagne's always cold and the music's always good, and the pretty girls just happen to stop by in the hood, and they hop their pretty ass up on the hood of that pretty ass car without a wrinkle in today, cause there's no tomorrow.
Round number two, here is song number eight.
But you made me look so nice. Me
all right, you're going to hear those songs one more time. Remember, the very good hint that you get is that some of them, well, all the songs sound kind of like brands of sunscreen. Regardless, second time around, here's song number one.
But you're moving so carefully, let's start living dangerously.
Talk to me, baby. I'm rolling up on this sweet, sweet, baby.
My body's saying let's go. My heart is saying no. It's
shows. I've been on the road, I don't care where I go, long as I keep paying. Bad little vibe, she been on my mind. Soon as I get back, she can slay. Do this all the time, this ain't no surprise. Every other night, another movie get made.
Every other night, another dollar get made. Every other night, started with a good day. I feel like a child, I got boogers in the face.
Where the sun is always out and you never get old, and the champagne's always cold, and the music's always good, and the pretty girls just happen to stop by in the hood, and they hop their pretty ass up on the hood of that pretty ass car without a wrinkle in today, cause there's no tomorrow.
There you go. That's round number two. Looking at the chat, Metal Yoga Head, I have heard of Power Wolf. I would use a sunscreen called Power Wolf. I really would. Death metal. I have a good friend who's super into death metal. He travels a lot. He's a photographer, and so he makes excuses to go photograph death metal concerts. Like, he went to Wacken and got a tent. He goes all over the country looking for metal bands. And he's always wearing shirts, and I'm like, what do they sound like? They're all pretty much, I mean, I can't differentiate it. I know that metal fans can. I'm not saying that they all sound the same, but what I'm saying is that I have a new title at Geeks Who Drink, and don't tell anyone, it's associate editor in charge of AV. So who knows? Maybe every now and then on a Monday, we'll have some metal. We'll see. We'll see. All right. Just don't hold your breath too hard, but I'll see what I can do for you. All right. I'll see what I can do. I also do want to talk about the round twos, because we do get a lot of complaints from quizzers that we play only recent pop music. And I can tell you specifically on Mondays, since the end of November of 2023, we've only played, I think only 6% of the songs have been from the last 4 years or 2 years. And then, but it's like less than 10% that have been from the last 4 years. The biggest chunk of music that we play is actually 10 to 30 years old. And then we go backwards and backwards and backwards from there. And we actually play just about the same percentage of Vietnam era and post Vietnam era hits as we do post pandemic hits. So it's weird, right? It's weird that sometimes the perception of, oh, I don't know this, so it must be new, is out there. What I'm saying is we don't play a lot of recent pop. We really don't. We play a lot of 90s and aughts. We do. We really do. We are stuck in the past. 10 to 30 years old. 10 to 30 years old is what we... The percentage of Rihanna, I don't have that figured out yet, Don Rico Suave, but... it's probably high. But yeah, people definitely only remember the ones they don't get. Anyway, regardless, rant over. We are going to move on to the answers for round two. Songs that sound kind of like sunscreen bands. Here's number one, sunscreen brands. Number one, that's Cake by the Ocean. So Cake It On by the Ocean from Dunce. I assume that's how you say that. Here's number two. Number two is Genie in a Bottle. That's Christina Aguilera. Christina Aguilera, Genie in a Bottle at number two. Here's number three. Number three is Mr. Brightside by The Killers. A song that I only heard for the first time like last year. So out of touch sometimes I am, having worked at an oldie station for so long. Here's number four. Soak Up the Sun by Sheryl Crow at number four. Mr. Grape Juice number one was Cake by the Ocean. Here's number five. Number five, that is Drip Too Hard. It's definitely rap. It's Lil Baby and Gunna. Drip Too Hard by Lil Baby and Gunna at number five. Here's number six. Number six, Cool for the Summer by Demi Lovato. Demi Lovato with Cool for the Summer at number six. Number seven. Number seven is Young Forever by Jay-Z featuring Mr. Hudson, who I assume is just his gym teacher. I don't know. Here's number eight. Number eight. That is Vampire by Olivia Rodrigo. Olivia Rodrigo with Vampire at number eight. Dream Crusher, bleeding me dry. Anyway, there you go. That's that. That is round number two. And the audio round from about a year ago, the audiobook thing, that was quite the departure. Stats tells us that, you know, it's kind of middle of the road on how people did. And I will also say those are very hard to populate, much harder than just a title and artist music round. But we're always looking for new ways to populate round two. So, you know, don't think that we'll never do it again. It's just not going to be all the time. So, yeah. Anyway, we are going to move on to round number three. Round number three is called Thrice-a-Roni. The last one inside of the last, but yeah, the last one is a very recent pop song, but we've also used it like a bunch. But I can tell you again, overall on Mondays, since late November, we don't play as much recent pop as people think we do. Anyway, round three, we're going to move on to round three. Round three is called Thrice-a-Roni, which is a hilarious title. What happens in this round is we give you the number of letters in a word and what a sentence might literally mean if we said that word three times and you give us the word three times. You get it? You dig? Anyway, here's an example. four letters. We need to find a specific calendar day for our romantic outing where we eat dried fruits from a palm tree. That's going to be a what. Of course, that is a date. You get it. You're going to do really well. And here we go. Number one. Question number one, three letters. Whenever I'm stuck in traffic, I like to turn on my favorite song about strawberry preserves. It's my what. Question one, once again, three letters in the word. Whenever I'm stuck in traffic, I like to turn on my favorite song about strawberry preserves. It's my what. Round number three, Thrice-a-Roni. Just tell me which word is being said three times. Here's question number two. Number two, five letters. Whoa, they're planning a whole parade dedicated to the family from Little Women next Women's History Month. It's going to be a what. Question two, once again, five letters. Whoa, they're planning a whole parade dedicated to the family from Little Women next Women's History Month. It's going to be a what. Yeah, originally this round was going to be called something else, and then our editor-in-chief was like, I'd like to call it Thrice-a-Roni, and I'm like, am I crazy? And I'm like, no, please do. Please call it Thrice-a-Roni. If you don't call it Thrice-a-Roni, you're doing it wrong. So, welcome to Thrice-a-Roni. Here is question number three. Number three, six letters. I once bowled three strikes in a row using a cooked bird while on vacation in Istanbul. It was the first ever what. Question three, six letters. I once bowled three strikes in a row using a cooked bird while on vacation in Istanbul. It was the first ever what. For a long time, our motto in the editorial department at Geeks Who Drink has been simple. Always harebrained, never half-assed. So just keep that in mind. We're in round number three, and we are at question number four. Number four, seven letters in the word. There's this weird phenomenon where ocean waves carry an electric charge. It's happening right now. It's a what? Question four, once again, seven letters. There's this weird phenomenon where ocean waves carry an electric charge, and it's happening right now. It's a what? Round number three, Thrice-a-Roni. And this round does kind of tie into round five tonight, just FYI. Here's question number five. Number five, six letters. If you lose this game where you hit a ball with rackets against the wall, I'll make you brutally stomp on a yellow gourd. It'll be a what? Question five, once again, six letters. If you lose this game where you hit a ball with rackets against the wall, I'm going to make you brutally stomp on a yellow gourd. It'll be a what? You know what else this round ties into? We have a daily trivia game called Thrice. I don't know if you've heard about it, but you can go to thricegame.com and you can play a daily trivia game made by us. And somebody recently did a TikTok where they were playing it on a toilet and it blew up. So, you know, be one of the first 100,000 to get in on it and play our Thrice game. It's daily trivia and it's pretty fun. We are in round number three and we're also at question number eight. No, the toilet didn't blow up. The game blew up, but... Man, wouldn't that be funny if the toilet blew up? Anyway, here's number six. 11 letters. Guys, I have a reason to be hesitant about placing a booking at a Navajo Nation restaurant. I have a what? Question six, once again, 11 letters. Guys, I have a reason to be hesitant about placing a booking at a Navajo Nation restaurant. I have a what? They say there's no such thing as bad publicity, so I guess if Thrice makes toilets blow up, play Thrice, right? Boom. We're in round three, and we are now at question number seven. Number seven, eight letters. Stop mixing chemicals you find in buildings where cults live. It just makes them worse. Every time you do it, you what? Question seven, once again, eight letters. Stop mixing chemicals you find in buildings where cults live. It just makes them worse. Every time you do it, you what? Round number three is question number eight. Number eight, six letters. Did you know that Napoleon kept a line of troops just to read newspaper features about ancient building supports? They were his what? Question eight, six letters. Did you know that Napoleon kept a line of troops just to read newspaper features about ancient building supports? They were his what? Round number three, Thrice-a-Roni. You just have to tell me which word is being said three times in each question. That is it for the questions proper, of course. The next step, all as always, is the bonus question. It's that bonus seven letters. It's a bad idea to try and bully or intimidate bison from Western New York's largest city. One should never what? Y'all are getting it all figured out just like I knew you would. And so we are going to move on to the answers for round number three. This round really read like dad jokes. Really, to me, it felt like I was just reading dad jokes. Number one, three letters. Whenever I'm stuck in traffic, I like to turn on my favorite song about strawberry preserves. It's my jam, 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 Holmes. Jam, jam, jam at number one. Number two, five letters. They're planning a whole parade dedicated to the family from Little Women next Women's History Month. That, of course, is going to be a march, march, march. March, march, march at number two. Marcha, marcha, marcha. Here we go. Number three. I once bowled three strikes in a row using a cooked bird while on vacation in Istanbul. That was the first ever turkey, turkey, turkey. Or turkey, I, turkey, turkey. You can use the new spelling of turkey, the spelling the turkey wants you to use. But turkey, turkey, turkey is the answer to number three. Number four. There's this weird phenomenon where ocean waves carry an electric charge, and it's happening right now. It's a current, current, current. Current, current, current at number four. Number five. If you lose this game where you hit a ball with rackets against a wall, I'm going to make you brutally stomp on a yellow gourd. It's going to be a squash, squash, squash. So squash, squash, squash at number five. Number six. Guys, I have a reason to be hesitant about placing a booking at a Navajo Nation restaurant. I have a reservation, reservation, reservation. Reservation, reservation, reservation at number six. Number seven. Stop mixing chemicals you find in buildings where cults live. It just makes them worse every time you do. It compound, compound, compound. Compound, compound, compound. And number eight. Did you know that Napoleon kept a line of troops just to read newspaper features about ancient building supports? Of course, they were his column, column, column. Column, column, column at number eight. And now, let's talk about the bonus question. It's a bad idea to try and bully or intimidate bison from Western New York's largest city. One should never buffalo, buffalo, buffalo. Buffalo, buffalo, buffalo at number nine, the bonus. And there you go. Round four tonight is called To the Gills. To the Gills is the round title. It's a round on fish and people with gill names. It's a round on fish and people with gill names. Here's number one. Number one, Gillian Jacobs is a Juilliard graduate, but she's best known for playing worst Greendale student Britta Perry on what bygone series? Question one, once again, Gillian Jacobs is a Juilliard graduate, but she's best known for playing worst Greendale student Britta Perry on what bygone series? Round number four, To the Gills. Here's question number two. Number two, he means octopus, au means marlin, and ahi means tuna. In the world of what delicious Hawaiian dish whose name means to slice? Question two, once again, he means octopus, au means marlin, and ahi means tuna. In the world of what delicious Hawaiian dish whose name means to slice? Round four, round about fish and also people with gill names. We are at question number three. Number three, comic book writer Joe Gill co-created what John Cena character who vows to end conflict no matter how many people he has to kill? Question three, once again, comic book writer Joe Gill co-created what John Cena character who vows to end conflict no matter how many people he has to kill? Round number four, question number four. Number four, the Country Music Hall of Fame is a short walk from the home of what NHL team whose fans like to throw catfish on the ice? Question four, once again, the Country Music Hall of Fame is a short walk from the home of what NHL team whose fans like to throw catfish on the ice? Round number four, question number five. We are at number five. Former PM Julia Gillard has advocated for the Uluru Statement from the Heart, a document calling for stronger Aboriginal rights in what country? Question five, once again, former PM Julia Gillard has advocated for the Uluru Statement from the Heart, a document calling for stronger Aboriginal rights in what country? Round number four, to the gills, fish, and also people that have gill names. Here's question number six. Number six, for their mating ritual of creating intricate sand nests, the white-spotted pufferfish was dubbed nature's greatest artist by what 98-year-old British documentarian? Question six, once again, for their mating ritual of creating intricate sand nests, the white-spotted pufferfish was dubbed nature's greatest artist by what 98-year-old British documentarian? Greg Gabo, good question. It kind of does sound like bargain bin run, run Rudolph, but what you know about Chuck Berry, you know anything about Chuck Berry, he recycled pretty much all of his riffs. So that would mean it is also bargain bin Little Queenie because they were the exact same song with different lyrics. It also sounded a little bit like Johnny B. Goode, pretty much everything he ever did. So it's called River Blues. It's by Track Tribe. Of course, it is royalty-free. Yeah. Anyway, we are at question number seven. Number seven, go land crabs. Jimmy McGill from Better Call Saul got his very legit law degree from a school in what only inhabited U.S. territory south of the equator. Question seven, once again, go land crabs. Jimmy McGill from Better Call Saul got his very legitimate law degree from a school in what only inhabited U.S. territory south of the equator. It's an oldie where I come from, but believe me, your kids are going to love it. Anyway, we are in round number four, to the gills, fish, and also people that have gill names. Let's do question number eight. Number eight, the Georgia Aquarium uses a 6-million-gallon tank to house what filter-feeding fish that gets bigger than belugas and humpbacks, just like their name says. Question eight, once again, the Georgia Aquarium uses a 6-million-gallon tank to house what filter-feeding fish that gets bigger than belugas and humpbacks, just like their name says. Yeah, I don't know why I took it off the screen. Probably because I, too, had the knee-jerk reaction of your mom. And then I just absentmindedly took it off the screen because I'm like, just put your mom. Everybody's going to put your mom anyway. So just do it. Anyway, that is round number four. It is called To the Gills. It is about fish. It's about people with gill names. And that is it for the questions proper. The only thing we have left to do in this round, duh, because I already put it on the screen, but I didn't put the question up, so I'm smart. You know what you're doing. You're going to do great. Weirdo screenwriter Charlie Kaufman once proposed a gritty cannibalistic reboot of what goofy 60s show about the wreck of the SS Minnow? Question nine, the bonus. Weirdo screenwriter Charlie Kaufman once proposed a gritty cannibalistic reboot of what Goofy 60's show about the wreck of the SS Minnow. Looks like you're all doing very well, just like I expected you to, getting those answers in. So get those answers in, give you a little time to get those entries flowing, and then we'll come back and we'll talk about the answers for round four in just a little bit. All right, that is round four. You know it, you love it. We need a command for your mom, don't we? Anyway, let's do the answers for round number four, starting at number one. Gillian Jacobs is a Juilliard graduate, but she's best known for playing worst Greendale student Britta Perry on the bygone series Community. Community at number one. Number two. He means octopus. Ao means marlin, and ahi means tuna. In the world of what delicious Hawaiian dish whose name means to slice, that, of course, is poke. Poke at number two. Number three. Comic book writer Joe Gill co-created what John Cena character who vows to end conflict no matter how many people he has to kill. That, of course, is Peacemaker. Peacemaker at number three. I was unfamiliar with Peacemaker until they did the spinoff show. And the only thing I've watched is just the YouTube video of the opening credits multiple times because it's friggin' hilarious. It looks like a fine show, but I was never into comic book heroes so much. So, you know, I'll leave it to the people who really enjoy that stuff to tell me how good it is. And people have told me it's pretty good. Here's number four. The Country Music Hall of Fame is a short walk from the home of what NHL team whose fans like to throw catfish on the ice? And it's the Nashville Predators. The Nashville Predators, they like to throw catfish. Florida likes to throw rats. Detroit likes to throw an octopus. Philadelphia likes to throw batteries, I think, pretty much at everybody. But the Nashville Predators, their fans, like to throw catfish on the ice. Number five. Former PM Julia Gillard has advocated for the Uluru Statement from the Heart, a document calling for stronger Aboriginal rights in Australia. Australia at number five. Number six, for their mating ritual of creating intricate sand nests, the white-spotted pufferfish was dubbed nature's greatest artist by what 98-year-old British documentarian? That would be David Attenborough. Sir David Attenborough at number six. Number seven, doody-doody-doo. Go Land Crabs, Jimmy McGill from Better Call Saul, got his very legitimate law degree from a school American Samoa, which of course is the only inhabited U.S. territory south of the equator. American Samoa at number seven. And here's number eight. Ba, ba, ba. The Georgia Aquarium uses a 6 million gallon tank to house what filter feeding fish that gets bigger than belugas and humpbacks. Just like their name says, this is definitely your mom. No, it's not. It's whale sharks. Whale sharks at number eight. Weirdo screenwriter Charlie Kaufman once proposed a gritty cannibalistic reboot of the goofy 60s show Gilligan's Island. I don't know why we always have to make the old stuff dark, but yeah, I don't know. I think Gilligan's Island is probably fine the way it is, but then again, if you want it to be weird and dark and cannibalistic, you go for it. Round five is the video round for the evening. I did say that round three kind of ties in a little bit with the title, so let's find out what the hell I'm talking about. It's called San Frandemonium. The Golden Gate Bridge opened on this day way back when. So to celebrate, you get to name these movies showing the bridge having a pretty bad day. Name each movie is number one.
Remember those invisible microwaves that Josh was talking about? Well, they just found a hole.
Called it Judgment Day. People lived like rats in the shadows, hiding.
Just found a hole.
Survivors called it Judgment Day.
Well, there you go. That is round number five. So name those movies. I'm sure you're going to do really, really good. Apparently the Golden Gate Bridge just gets destroyed a lot in popular culture. I don't know why. I don't know what popular culture has against that particular bridge, but maybe they had relatives in Alcatraz. I don't know. Oh, hello. We are back from break. That was a pretty quick 3 minutes, but hey. I used the time while the video round was playing to make myself another drink. So I just sat here and contemplated having another drink because I have another drink. So I contemplated, ooh, I should be drinking it. I was like, nah, it'll be fine. I'll drink it eventually. Anyway, welcome back to the quiz. We have burned through the first five rounds. The only thing we have left to do is the answers for round five, round six answers. Final round answers. I think that's it. Yeah. So why not talk about those round five answers? San Fran Demodium. Your name in movies where the Golden Gate Bridge gets frickin' wrecked. Number one is Rise of the Planet of the Apes. There are some angry monkeys. And if they're not monkeys, don't at me. I don't care. Here's number two. As Godzilla. Old Godzilla at number two. Number three. That particular X-Men movie is X-Men The Last Stand. X-Men The Last Stand at number three. Number four. Monsters v. Aliens. It's Monsters versus Aliens at number four. Number five. You see The Rock, what could it be? Many things, actually, but this is San Andreas in particular. San Andreas at number five. Number six. That's the core. The core at number six. Number seven. Terminator Genesis, which is not quite as cool as Sega Genesis, but Terminator Genesis at number seven. Here's number eight. That is the Book of Eli. The Book of Eli at number eight. So we have gone through those answers for round five. And yeah, I did say don't at me. I know they're not really monkeys, so thank you for not adding me, Metal Yoga Head. I know it's called Planet of the Apes, not Planet of the Monkeys, but I also don't like dystopian fiction. So I'm just going to ignore it and pretend it's not happening. So round six, Terminator Mega Drive in the UK. That's a solid joke, Great Gabo, and only a select few people will get it. So thank you for that. Anyway, round six is the second 16-point round of the evening. It's called Bill's Gone Wild. Happy 187th birthday to Wild Bill Hickok. He would be celebrating, but he's dead. To celebrate, we are giving other famous people new nicknames. So this is a round of two-part questions. The answer to each first part will be an adjective, and the answer to the second part will be a person. It's pretty simple, and then you can just put them together and make a new nickname out of it if you want. If not, who cares? Just answer the question. Get some points, right? That's what we're all about. We're just all about that paper. So my brother in quiz, let's get those points. Here is question number one. Steve Carell, Magic Johnson, and a minion appeared in the video for what 2013 Pharrell Jam? And whoa, who had cameos as Batman in DC League of Super Pets, Duke Kaboom in Toy Story 4, and himself in Always Be My Maybe? Round six, question one. Once again, Steve Carell, Magic Johnson, and a minion appeared in the video for what 2013 Pharrell Jam? And whoa, who had cameos as Batman in DC League of Super Pets, Duke Kaboom in Toy Story 4, and himself in Always Be My Maybe? Yeah, I was definitely on the side of Sega growing up. My friend had a Nintendo, and I had a Sega Master System, and then they came out with the Genesis, and I'm like, Sega all the way. And then when I got older and I got a job and I wanted to play Mortal Kombat at home, I realized that the old Sega Genesis didn't handle transparencies as well as the Super Nintendo. So I bought a Super Nintendo. Now I have a Wii that I play Power Pros 2008 on, if that tells you what kind of a gamer I am. I'm not much of a gamer. But I did recently buy the newest version of the PlayStation so that my kid and I can play NHL 24. And I'll tell you what, that game sucks. I mean, EA, when they say it's in the game, they fucking lie. I'm going to tell you that right now. It's fun to just build overpowered teams and beat the hell out of each other, but it ain't a good game. It's really a bad game. Sidetrack. Anyway, we're at question number two. NHL 95 is where it's at, right? Blood on the ice. Last month, Wired said, now's a good time to stop thinking that what Chrome mode is actually private. And known for disappearing into his roles, who gained 40 pounds for Vice and lost 60 pounds for The Machinist? Question two, once again, last month, Wired said, now's a good time to stop thinking that what Chrome mode is actually private. And known for disappearing into his roles, who gained 40 pounds for Vice and lost 60 pounds for The Machinist? Lethal Corpse. Yes, I can explain the round again. Ostensibly, the person who wrote this round wanted it to be new nicknames for people. So the first, for each pair of questions, the first answer is going to be an adjective, and the second answer is going to be a person. You can take the nickname thing or leave it, but it's still a round of two-part questions. Or the first answer is going to be an adjective and the second is going to be a person. I hope that explains the round well enough. If it doesn't, let me know and I'll make something up. Here's question number three. Number three, what 2012 what Pixar film? What 2012 Pixar film starred the first Disney princess to have neither a love interest nor a song? And featuring couples of fraught love interests and lots of singing, the Broadway hit Waitress had music by what Girls 5 Eva star? Question three, once again, what 2012 Pixar film starred the first Disney princess to have neither a love interest or a song? And featuring a couple of fraught love interests and a lot of singing, the Broadway hit Waitress had music by what Girls 5 Eva star? And I am going to read you a dictionary definition of an adjective. That is a word or phrase naming an attribute added to or grammatically related to a noun to modify or describe it. So basically, an adjective describes something, you know, like fun or fast. Hopefully, that helps. I didn't do really very well in English. However, I played a lot of Mad Libs when I was a kid, so if you played a lot of Mad Libs, probably do okay. Here's round six, question number four. 16 big points on the line in this round. Question four, part one. Marseille Martin was 10 when she pitched what 2019 film, whose plot is basically a reverse Big, and is one of the few people he literally looks up to. What Inside the NBA host said Yao Ming was the only guy who really tested him. Question four, once again, Marseille Martin was 10 when she pitched what 2019 film, whose plot is basically reverse Big, and is one of the few people he literally looks up to. What Inside the NBA host said Yao Ming was the only guy who really tested him. Round number six, Bill's gone wild. 16 big points on the line. We've got two-part questions where the first answer is an adjective, the second is a person, and we are at question number five. Number five, Slenderman is the most famous character from the internet genre called what pasta? And what Radiohead singer said, "I'm not afraid of computers taking over the world. They're just sitting there. I can hit them with a 2x4. Question five, once again, Slenderman is the most famous character from the internet genre called what pasta? And what Radiohead singer said, "I'm not afraid of computers taking over the world. They're just sitting there. I can hit them with a 2x4. Round number six, 16 big points possible in the round. We are at question number six. That's a lot of sixes. Ooh, question of the beast. Anyway, number six, Sig Nick Offerman, LeVar Burton, and Harry Styles all read sleep stories on what Headspace competitor? And last month, what singer went from rainbows to kiss paint with the song Karma? Question six, once again, Nick Offerman, LeVar Burton, and Harry Styles all read sleep stories on what Headspace competitor? And last month, what singer went from rainbows to kiss paint with the song Karma? I'm going to have to get me a new chair. This one's starting to squeak. A couple of screws didn't make it. It's a cheap chair. I mean, I got to admit, I didn't pay a lot for it. A couple of the screws stripped out, and now it squeaks when I move. Ugh. Got to get a new chair. I should pay a lot for a chair. You think you should pay a lot for a chair because you're going to sit in it all day. But then I'm like, I don't want to pay too much for a chair, and then I get mad when the chair doesn't work real well. Anyway, I don't know why I said that. It doesn't matter because we are in a quiz round called Bills Gone Wild. 16 points you could have in your points bank. Here's number seven. Question number seven. Gadbury Sadib's first pro acting gig was the title role in what 2009 Best Picture nominee? And I Can't Swim was the moving line spoken by what actor who ditched his usual mocap suit for Andor? Question seven, once again, Gadbury Sadib's first pro acting gig was the title role in what 2009 Best Picture nominee? And I Can't Swim was the moving line spoken by what actor who ditched his usual motion cap suit for Andor? I like the Jerfad's joke, by the way. It's a pretty good joke. It's a pretty good joke there about adverbs and adjectives. But guess what? Princely, I think, is an adverb. And if you paid a princely sum for a steel case desk chair, but it's worth it, I'm going to have to look into those. Because I hate this chair. We are at question number eight in round six. Mark Zuckerberg is CEO of what four-letter company? And who is Meta's CEO? Question eight. Once again, Mark Zuckerberg is CEO of what four-letter company? And who is Meta's CEO? Don't you shame me. It's time for the bonus question. Let's do that bonus. Wild Bill supposedly had two pairs, aces and eights, when he was shot in the back of the head while playing what game? All right, round number six, called Bills Gone Wild. Two-part questions. First answer to each part is an adjective. Second one is a person. So let's find out those answers right now. Number one, Steve Carell, Magic Johnson, and a minion appeared in the video for the 2013 Pharrell Jam Happy. And who had cameos as Batman in DC League of Super Pets, Duke Kaboom, and Toy Story 4? And himself and Always Be My Maybe. That, of course, is Keanu Reeves. So... happy Keanu Reeves at number one. Number two. Last month, Wired said, now's a good time to stop thinking that what Chrome mode is actually private. That is incognito. Known for disappearing into his roles, who gained 40 pounds for Vice and lost 60 pounds for The Machinist. That is Christian Bale. Incognito and Christian Bale at number two. Number three, what 2012 Pixar film starred the first Disney princess to have neither a love interest or a song? That, of course, is Brave. And featuring a couple of fraught love interests and a lot of singing, the Broadway hit Waitress had music by Sarah Bareilles. Brave, Sarah Bareilles at number three. Number four, Marseille Martin was 10 when she pitched the 2019 film whose plot is basically reverse big. It's called Little. And as one of the few people he literally looks up to, the Inside the NBA host who said Yao Ming was the only guy who really tested him, that, of course, is Shaquille O'Neal. Little Shaquille O'Neal at number four. Number five, Slenderman is the most famous character from the internet genre called Creepypasta. And the Radiohead singer who said, I'm not afraid of computers taking over the world. They're just sitting there. I can hit him with a 2x4. That is Tom York. Creepy Tom York at number five. Number six. Nick Offerman, LeVar Burton, and Harry Styles all read sleep stories on the Headspace competitor called Calm. And last month, the singer who went from rainbows to kiss paint with the song Karma, that is JoJo Siwa. Calm JoJo Siwa at number six. Number seven. Gaburi Sidibe's first pro acting gig was the title role in Precious. And I Can't Swim was the moving line spoken by what actor who ditched his usual motion capture suit for Andor, that is Andy Serkis. Precious Andy Serkis at number seven. Number eight, Mark Zuckerberg is the CEO of Meta. And the CEO of Meta is Mark Zuckerberg. Meta's Mark Zuckerberg at number eight. You love it. Don't think you didn't. So admit it, you loved it. Now, we're going to move on to the bonus question answer. Oh, Stellarella Melon is not the worst round ever. We've had worse rounds, right? Come on. Oh, don't say that. Oh, it'll make somebody sad. Not me. Not going to make me sad. Somebody out there is going to be sad. You don't want to make people sad. You don't want to make people all cry. Anyway, Wild Bill supposedly had two pairs, aces and eights, of course, now known as Dead Man's Hand, when he was shot in the back of the head playing poker. Poker is your bonus answer. Pretty much all of you knew that. We are going to move on to the final round. The final round is the random knowledge round. This is where anything can happen. 16 possible points if you saved your joker. God damn, you're a genius.
Can you dig it?
Like I said, this is the final round. It is a random knowledge round. It is also a 16-point round. That means some of the questions are going to have multiple parts, be worth multiple points. So, yes, it behooves you to pay close attention. However, I'm going to tell you how much each question is worth. And the best part is it's on a screen. So that's a lot of different ways to figure out how much each question is worth. I don't think you got an excuse to not know how much each question is worth. And some of you still have Tabor credit. That's awesome. You should use it. Anyway, question number one, we're going to start here. Coincidentally worth 1 point. A British newspaper made the first May the 4th be with you pun in 1979 while wishing luck to what prime minister who was basically Darth Vader? Question one, once again, a British newspaper made the first May the 4th be with you pun in 1979. While wishing luck to what prime minister who was basically Darth Vader? I do like that so many Americans have opinions about British prime ministers, but, you know, you'll do fine. Here is question number two. Number two is a 2-point question. Broomgate is a new Canadian podcast about a 2015 scandal in what slippery sports, and in 1994 and again in 2011, what usually cool Canadian city rioted when its team lost game 7 of the Stanley Cup Finals. Question two, once again, 2 points. Broomgate is a new Canadian podcast about a 2015 scandal. Excuse me, sorry. In what slippery sport? In 1994 and again in 2011, what usually cool Canadian city rioted when its team lost game 7 of the Stanley Cup Finals? Final round, random knowledge question number three. Number three is a one-point question, and it's the anagram question. You love those. What heavenly natural phenomenon anagrams to Airbus or Areola? You have your anagram and scramble it. Find your answer. Question three once again. What heavenly natural phenomenon anagrams to Airbus or Areola? Coming to NBC this fall, Airbus or Areola. It is a sequel to Is It Cake? Final round, random knowledge, 16 points on the line. We are at question number four. Number four is a three-point question. Which U.S. president's name completes the title of each Wikipedia article? Blank shoeing incident, blank tan suit controversy, and blank's enemies list. Question four, once again, 3 points. Which U.S. president's name completes the title of each Wikipedia article? First one, blank shoeing incident. Second one, blank tan suit controversy. Third one, blank's enemies list. Final round, random knowledge, question number five. Number five is a one-point question. According to the scientists at Apple Music, the greatest album of all time is the one, it should have a one in there, I guess, the one and only studio offering from what miseducated Fuji. Question five, once again, according to the scientists at Apple Music, the greatest album of all time is the one and only studio offering from what miseducated Fuji. Final round, random knowledge. You got 16 big points on the line here. I mean, if you've saved your joker, that's awesome, right? You might win. Ooh, that's exciting. Number six. Number six is a 3-point question. For each song from a recent Broadway musical, you name the 80s film it was adapted from. Deo, It's Only a Matter of Time, and Talk to Me, Dorothy. Question six, once again, 3 points. Each entry is a song from a recent Broadway musical. You have to tell me what 80s film each of those musicals was adapted from. Keep in mind, 80s film. Deo, It's Only a Matter of Time, and Talk to Me, Dorothy. I tell you what, I have seen some bonkers ass movie adaptations into musicals. I have seen one of these on the list, and it's fucking bonkers. FYI. There's more that I'll tell you about come answer time that were fucking bonkers. You ever watch Bob's Burgers? You see those things that Gene Belcher puts on? Sometimes you're sitting in a legitimate theater watching a legitimate Broadway touring cast put on something that you're like, did Gene Belcher write this? It's amazing. So it's just bonkers. Anyway, we are in the final round, and we have 16 points available to you. And we are at question number 7, which of course is worth 1 point, but it might be the 1 point you need to win the game. So we'll find out together. South African naturalists have spent over 30 years trying to breed back the partially striped quagga, an extinct subspecies of what hoofed animal? Question number 7. Once again, South African naturalists have spent over 30 years trying to breed back the partially striped quagga, an extinct subspecies of what hoofed animal? See, Greg Gabo, all you had to do was wait, and you got your behooving question. Anyway, we are in the final round, and the only thing left to do in the questions proper is question number 8. Number 8. There it is. 4 big points, all well west of the Mississippi, and none named Arizona. Which 4 U.S. states are home to the most federally recognized Native American tribes? Question 8, 4 points once again, all well west of the Mississippi, and none named Arizona. Which 4 U.S. states are home to the most federally recognized Native American tribes? All right, final round, random knowledge. It is time for the final bonus question of the evening. But anyway, let's do that bonus question for this final round of quiz. In 1961, an upholsterer brought home a 50-foot roll of naga hide. So begins the creation myth of what summer backyard toy that a recall once warned could cause permanent spinal injury? Exclamation point and the answer. It is 3 parts, so a word, a letter, and a word. There you go. We got something going. In 1961, an upholsterer brought home a 50-foot roll of naga hide. So begins the creation myth of what summer backyard toy that a recall once warned could cause permanent spinal injury. I'm going to give you a little time to get those answers in, so do that. Get those entries, and then I'll come back in just a little bit, and we'll go over the answers to this final round. All right, final round. Let's do those answers right now. 16 big points on the line in this round. Number 1, a British newspaper made the first May the 4th be with you pun in 1979 while wishing luck to Margaret Thatcher. Margaret Thatcher at number 1. Number 2. 2 points. Broomgate is a new Canadian podcast about a 2015 scandal in curling. Take curling very seriously up there. And in 1994 and again in 2011, the usually cool Canadian city that rioted when its team lost game 7 of the Stanley Cup Finals. During the read-through, one of our new writers slash fact-checkers shouted Toronto, and I bust out laughing because, I mean, if you're a hockey fan, you know that Toronto can't get past the first goddamn round. That's kind of snake bit. Have been since the 60s. No, it's Vancouver. Curling and Vancouver at number 2. If you don't know hockey, well, Toronto's still a funny answer because it's not right. All right, number 3. What heavenly natural phenomenon anagrams to Airbus or Areola? That, of course, is Aurora Borealis. Aurora Borealis at number 3. Number 4. 3 points. You had to name each president from the Wikipedia article blank shoeing incident. That, of course, is W. George W. Bush. blank tan suit controversy. That is Barack Obama. And blank's enemies list is Richard Nixon. George W. Bush, Barack Obama, and Richard Nixon at number four. Number five. According to the scientists at Apple Music, the greatest album of all time is the one and only studio offering from the miseducated Fuji, Lauryn Hill. Lauryn Hill at number five. Number six. 3 points. Name each 80s film from its Broadway adaptation musical number. Deo, of course, is Beetlejuice. It's only a matter of time. Think about an 80s movie about time, and you'll probably come up with Back to the Future. And Talk to Me Dorothy is, of course, Tootsie. And if you put Wizard of Oz, you're about 50 years too late. So Beetlejuice, Back to the Future, and Tootsie at number six. I saw the Tootsie musical. It was slightly better than the Officer and a Gentleman musical. And if you've never seen the Officer and a Gentleman musical, you should see it. It's like a train wreck. You can't look away, but it's one of the worst things I've ever seen. Comically bad. Like, we were laughing in the third act at very inappropriate times, but it's their fault. It's their fault for putting it on. Anyway, Beetlejuice, Back to the Future, and Tootsie at number six. Number seven. South African naturalists have spent over 30 years trying to breed back the partially striped quagga, which is an extinct subspecies of a zebra, or zebra, as we say it in this country. But yeah, 1970s was The Wiz, 1930s was The Wizard of Oz, and Tootsie was early 80s. I remember seeing that in a movie theater. My dad used to manage movie theaters when I was a kid. That was a pretty fun way to grow up. Let's see. What do we got? Pick a winner. And we're going to go on to number eight. Number eight, 4 points. All well west of the Mississippi in none named Arizona, the four U.S. states that are home to the most federally recognized Native American tribes is Alaska, California, Oklahoma, and Washington. Alaska, California, Oklahoma, and Washington. Now I got to check and see if this is a viable winner. Are you a viable winner? Are you my winner? Maybe so. Looks like it. That's cool. Let's copy and paste it in a couple of different places. And then, boom. All right. Bonus question. Speaking of, 1961, an upholsterer brought home a 50-foot roll of Naga hide, so begins the creation myth of what summer backyard toy that a recall once warned could cause permanent spinal injury. That is a slip and slide. I'm going to tell you that I had a pretty serious head injury on a slip and slide when I was in Cub Scouts. So spinal injury not far behind. It was a dangerous freaking toy, but also a hell of a lot of fun if you didn't have any regard for your well-being. Thanks again for hanging out with us on a bank holiday. It's Memorial Day. It's a Monday Memorial Day. So thanks so much for having fun having quiz with us tonight. Don't forget, we do these quizzes live in other places. So check out the schedule in your area and go see a real cool live quiz. And if there are no quizzes in your area, get in touch with us and we'll figure something out. But also, you know, if you're ever in Colorado Springs on a Thursday evening, come see me at the public house at the Alexander. Some of you have, and it was a lot of fun. Yeah, I know what broken ribs feel like, Metal Yoga Head. I got one right here, and it's not my first. So I sympathize with you. I am glad I'm alive, too. Thank you so much. Thank you all for spending your Monday evening with me. Wherever you are, be safe, have fun, and we will see you back again next Monday. Good night.